श्रील प्रभुपाद की जाए। सो यस्टरडे वी बिगैन अ वेरी ब्यूटिफुल फेस्टिवल ऑफ चंदन यात्रा, अक्षय तृतीया, द डे वेन चंदन यात्रा बिगिन्स, एंड दिस चंदन यात्रा कंटिन्यूज फॉर 21 डेज। वॉट इज सो स्पेशल अबाउट दिस चंदन यात्रा दैट एवरी ईयर वी परफॉर्म दिस चंदन यात्रा सिंस टाइम इमेमोरियल? लेट अस गेट अ ब्रीफ आइडिया ऑफ वेयर दिस ट्रेडिशन हैज कम फ्रॉम एंड वॉट इज सो स्पेशल अबाउट दिस सेवा। डज लॉर्ड लाइक इट? इज देर एनी ग्लोरिफिकेशन ऑफ डिवोटीज अबाउट दिस सेवा टू द लॉर्ड? एंड ऑल्सो वेर इन शास्त्र मेन्शंस अबाउट द एप्लीकेशन ऑफ चंदन, एंड इन द एंड इफ टाइम परमिट्स विल ऑल्सो मेन्शन अबाउट द ब्यूटिफुल पास टाइम्स ऑफ लॉर्ड गौरांगा विद चंदन। सो द ट्रेडिशन ऑफ चंदन बिगैन मैनी मैनी ईयर्स बैक। इट इज सेड द फर्स्ट टाइम चंदन यात्रा गॉट इट्स एग्जिस्टेंस ड्यूरिंग द टाइम ऑफ कृतयुग सत्ययुग वेन इंद्रद्युम्न महाराज establish the temple of Jagannath Puri and Lord Jagannath, Balabhadra and Subhadra Devi were installed there in the presence of Brahmaji. It is said that Lord Jagannath would speak to Indradyumna Maharaj regularly, and in this way whatever traditions are followed in Jagannath temple, Lord Jagannath had spoken many of those traditions to Indradyumna Maharaj and later to many of his devotees to come years after. So it is said that when the installation ceremony took place, Lord Jagannath was installed in Jagannath Puri. That time Lord Jagannath told Indradyumna Maharaj that during the month of Vaishakh it is a very hot time, so I would like you to smear the paste of chandan on my body and do it for 21 days and call this as a very special festival called as Chandan Yatra. So you find this Chandan Yatra got its place in the scriptures through the medium of Lord Jagannath. Lord Jagannath began this Chandan Yatra festival right in Satyuga, and from that time, since time immemorial, for various kalpas this festival is going on, wherein in the hot season of summer, Vaishakh month, on the day of Akshaya Tritiya, Chandan Yatra begins for the next 21 days. So in Jagannath Puri they elaborately worship Lord Jagannath with Chandan Yatra, because the origin of Chandan Yatra has happened in Jagannath Puri. Amazingly, it is said that there is a special vesha, a costume in Jagannath Puri named after Chandan. That's called Chandan Lagi Vesh. Now Jagannath is known for very meticulous dressing. Lord Jagannath, he changes his dress 8 times in the day, and every time he changes dress, then Jagannath has to eat special bhoga. So in this way, throughout the day, it is mentioned that Lord Jagannath eats 56 bhoga, 56 offerings. So amazing, Lord Jagannath is a good connoisseur of items. He likes to eat offered by his devotees. And Jagannath also likes to dress. So one of the dresses Lord Jagannath has, which also has varieties, it's not that the same 8 dresses Lord Jagannath wears every season. No, every different season the dresses changes. So it is mentioned that during the Vaishakha season, which is now starting yesterday, and the next month Jyeshtha, these 2 months, for 42 days, the last Shringar of Lord Jagannath in Jagannath Puri temple is Chandan Lagi. We have already known through many pastimes of Lord Jagannath that Lord Jagannath, he adores a very beautiful dress all throughout the year in the night time called as Bada Shringar Vesh, big Shringar, where he is decorated with flowers, beautiful flowers, saints and all other natural items. And it is said that Lord Jagannath is preparing himself so that in the night time he can go and meet the gopis of Vrindavan. So the night dress is always full of natural decorations. However, for the next 42 days of Vaishakh and Jyeshtha, starting from yesterday, Lord Jagannath will also be anointed with special chandan, and therefore the dress of Bada Shringar culminates in Chandan Lagi Vesh. It is said that great demigods come to meet Lord Jagannath every day. sometimes even Brahmaji comes, sometimes Lord Shiva also comes. So there is a mention that when the 21 days Chandan Yatra festival, apart from Chandan Lagi, 42 days of Chandan Lagi Vesha, the dress, there is also the 21 day authentic original tradition preserved, where the deities of Madan Mohan, the Utsav Vigra of Lord Jagannath, is called as Madan Mohan. They are decorated with Chandan, full smear all over the body, and just the eyes I have kept open. And for 21 days, like we have Chandan Yatra here in Gaudiya Vaishnavism, they also have Chandan Yatra, where Madan Mohan is smeared with Chandan, and Madan Mohan occasionally also goes out to perform Nauka Vihar, boat pastimes, in Narendra Sarovar. So these are very beautiful pastimes. Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also took part in those pastimes. So they said this 21 days of festival of Chandan Yatra, which starts from Akshaya Tritiya, it is said in Jagannath Puri, Lord Brahma himself resides. He comes in a very ordinary form. He may take any form. People do not recognize him. But he comes, and every day he comes to worship Lord Jagannath in this Chandan Yatra festival. Similarly, there are so many descriptions of Lord Shiva coming on a particular occasion for a festival. Like it is mentioned, Lord Shiva comes for the Snan Purnima. What is Snan Purnima? Snan Purnima is the day of the birthday of Lord Jagannath when he was installed in Satyuga. That day they offer, they bring Lord Jagannath out of temple on the Snan Vedi Vesh near the Anand Bazaar, and they pour waters and waters, pots of waters on Lord Jagannath, Balbhadra and Subhadra Devi. So that's called Snan Purnima, and amazingly Lord Jagannath becomes sick after that. But on the day of Snan Purnima, Lord Shiva also visits. And Lord Shiva, it is said in Shastra how he visits. He takes the form of a sadhu with a trishul in hand. Now it's very difficult to find that sadhu because there are so many sadhus with trishul in hand that time. But nonetheless, Lord Shiva comes in that form. And then Lord Shiva also comes during the Dol Yatra, the swing pastimes of Lord Jagannath. And that time Lord Shiva comes as an ordinary devotee, but he wears a very big garland. So these are some features, symptoms mentioned in the Shastra in Jagannath history. Lord Jagannath history, where great demigods, great devotas, great devotees of the Lord also participate in such festivals. So this is something about the tradition, how it has begun from Jagannath Puri. And now throughout the world we have this Chandan Yatra festival, thanks to Gaudiya Vaishnava devotees, thanks to other Vaishnavism, Vaishnavas of north, south, east, west, all directions. Everywhere Chandan Yatra is celebrated with great joy and happiness. Thanks to Srila Prabhupada, he has made Chandan Yatra famous all over the world. So this Chandan Yatra tradition is very simple. Why do Lord want Chandan? That may be a question asked. Why do Lord want Chandan? Is Lord not very cool? Is Lord very hot? No, the Lord is very kind to his devotees. The Lord gives a chance for the devotees to offer some service. So there is always a daily offering of bhoga, shringar, aarti, which we offer daily to the Lord. But Lord also gives a variety to his devotees to offer him. And one such variety is the Chandan Yatra festival. In this festival, Lord suddenly, or rather very transcendentally, become very hot. Many pastimes are there where Lord has told about, told his devotees in dreams that, please, I am feeling very hot, apply Chandan on my head. So Chandan plays a very vital role in the pastimes of the Lord, in the Shringar of the Lord, in the Archa Vigra deity rules and regulations. It is said that there are many upcharas with which the Lord is offered puja, and there is Esha Dhupa, that is offering Agarbatti or offering Dhupa. Esha Deepa is offering a lamp. Arghyam is water, and Achmanim is glow water, offering Achman, purification. And also part of this ritual, a part of this, all these different wonderful deity rules and regulations, there is one more beautiful rule and regulation, is offering Gandha. Like many times you may see in ISKCON temple, they offer scented flower in the morning. That's called Esha Gandha. However, the best Gandha as per scripture is Gandha offered in the form of sandalwood paste. Esha Gandha Seva. And you find that when the deities are offered every day Shringar, first there is bathing in the water there is some chandan, and also apart from there, there is then the decoration of the Lord, there is offering of flower garlands, and ultimately there is also the end. It ends with, the whole Shringar ends with offering of chandan and tulsi to the Lord. So tulsi is used, chandan is used, both together they are smeared and they are offered at the lotus feet of the Lord. So there are various reasons why Lord likes chandan. It is said chandan has many beneficial activities. As per Ayurveda, chandan is applied on the forehead when the head, matha, is very hot. And usually in summer, the head becomes very hot. So therefore, they apply chandan on the forehead. So it cools down the nerves in the head. And also it is mentioned that it also gives beautiful fragrance. So chandan has two points of activity. One is cooling down, another is fragrance. So it cools the head and it also gives fragrance. So as per Ayurveda, cooling is for cooling down the head, and the fragrance is for soothing the mind. So we find that Lord Jagannath or Lord Krishna, when they accept the chandan, they accept the chandan in the form of archavigra, so that it resembles that Lord also wants to be cooled down, Lord also wants his mind to be very peaceful. But nonetheless, the whole idea is when the chandan is offered, after the chandan is offered, chandan comes back as Mahaprasad, and then the devotees, they accept the chandan on their forehead, and the same effect which Lord wants on his own self in a usual pastime manner is actually enhancing or helping the devotee in their Krishna consciousness. Like Uddhavji, very close to Lord Krishna, so he mentions in the 11th canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, Uddhav is well known for using only Lord's paraphernalia on his body. He would wear garland which was offered to Krishna. He would wear clothes which were discarded by Krishna. Everything was always Krishna related items. So Uddhavji glorifies all these items. He says anyone who wears Krishna's Mahagarland, anyone who wears Krishna's Mahacloth, anyone who wears or applies Krishna's Mahachandan, Uddhavji says that those devotees who accept Mahaprasad of the Lord on their body, those devotees by accepting this Mahaprasad can overcome the snare of illusion, overcome Maya. So this is the glory of Chandan Yatra tradition, that first the Lord and the benefit goes to the devotee as well. Now in the history of this world, there are so many devotees who have received mercy of the Lord directly on account of this Chandan Yatra festival. Now, immediately the name which can we can refer is the name of Shripad Madhavendra Puri Goswami and Gopalji. Like this, there are unlimited devotees in the Vaishnava tradition where Krishna came in the dream of a devotee and told him to apply Chandan on his body. Now, a very important thing to note is that in Chaitanya Charitamrita, this beautiful story is mentioned about Gopalji asking for Chandan. The story is very vast. It takes many chapters. But we will primarily more focus on the later part, that is called as the Chandan Yatra and the Gopalji episode. So we all know that Madhavendra Puri Goswami, he was doing Govardhan Parikrama, and Lord Gopal came in his dream. And Lord Gopal told Madhavendra Puri that I am hiding in a bush. Please kindly remove me. I am waiting for you to come and render service to me. And then later, Gopalji is excavated from that bush near Govardhan and installed on top of Govardhan as per his wish. And Madhavendra Puri Goswami immediately arranges the small temple and the facility of bathing the deity, offering bhoga. And for months together, different villages are coming together and offering Chapan Bhoga, Govardhan Annakut in front of Lord Giriraj, and Lord from Govardhan Nath, Gopalji. Gopalji or later became Shri, later was called as Srinathji. There are so many beautiful pastimes of Gopalji. Now, after the whole worship was established, everything was settled. There were so many disciples of Madhavendra Puri Goswami in the village coming from outside, who began the worship of Gopalji. Now it was Gopalji who very amazingly engaged his devotee into yet another service which was much more difficult than the previous one. He came in the dream of Madhavendra Puri Goswami and told, "My dear Puri Goswami, kindly go to fetch Malaya Chandan, because for many years I have been underground and I am feeling hot, and now also that feeling of heat is in my body. So kindly go and fetch enough chandan which you can bring back and apply it on my body." So Madhavendra Puri Goswami, he has no idea what chandan is all about, how to fetch it and all, but being inspired by Lord's dream, immediately Madhavendra Puri Goswami starts on his journey towards Jagannath Puri, and he knows Jagannath Puri is a place where, from where he could fetch lot of chandan. Can be of different varieties, but specifically Malaya Chandan is very famous all over the world. So with that idea of getting Malaya Chandan, Shripad Madhavendra Puri Goswami, he goes to Jagannath Puri. To make the whole story little more shorter, Madhavendra Puri Goswami reaches Gopinath Diti, the temple of Gopinath in Remuna, and the beautiful pastime of Gopinath stealing the sweet rice happens, and he becomes very famous. And then he goes to Jagannath Puri. The fame of Madhavendra Puri Goswami reaches Jagannath Puri before he reaches Jagannath Puri, and as a result, Madhavendra Puri Goswami is completely bound by the love of the devotees and the Lord. He uses that fame in getting the chandan for Gopalji. He brings the chandan, and he is carrying around 37 to 40 kg of chandan. He carries that chandan with proper government permissions and is moving towards from Orissa towards Vrindavan. On the way, he again comes to this temple of Khirchur Gopinath, and it is mentioned that Lord Gopal comes in a dream again and he says, "Madhavendra Puri, I see that you are working so hard trying to please me, but kindly understand this one thing, that myself, Gopalji, and Gopinath, they are same. So you don't have to worry. Whatever chandan you have got, kindly apply it on the body of Gopinath, and I will receive the same effect on my body." So with that intention, Madhavendra Puri Goswami begins the Chandan Yatra festival in the temple of Khirchur Gopinath in Remuna. So this is such a beautiful pastime of how Lord, he is asking his devotee that kindly please bring chandan and you apply it on my body to make me cool down. So we find there are unlimited stories in the histories of Vaishnavism where such wonderful pastime has taken place, where Lord has come in the dream of devotees. I like to speak one more pastime, which was also the pastime for yesterday in Akshaya Tritiya. It is from the great Simhachalam temple in Andhra, in Vishakhapatnam, Andhra Pradesh. It is said that Prahlad Maharaj, he was tortured by his father Hiranyakashipu, and there are many ways Hiranyakashipu wanted to kill his son. So one time Hiranyakashipu became very upset that Prahlad is not getting killed, and suddenly he got an idea, why not throw him in the ocean? So he called his soldiers and told Prahlad has to be thrown in the ocean. So all the soldiers came in the coastal area, and the coastal area they came, and it was at this place near Vishakhapatnam. They came to this place and they threw Prahlad in the ocean, and when they threw Prahlad in the ocean, he went inside deep in the ocean. Now to make doubly sure that he dies, they lifted, all these demons lifted a huge boulder, a mountain, and threw it at the exact place in the ocean where they had thrown Prahlad Maharaj, with the idea that the boulder falls on Prahlad Maharaj and he is dead, no chance of any survival. However, Lord Vishnu is always eager to serve his devotees, protect his devotees. How can he let this happen? Prahlad Maharaj was completely equipoised, praying to Krishna. So Lord Narayan, it is mentioned, he jumped into the ocean, and he, just like Krishna lifted Giriraj to save his devotees in Braj, Lord Narayan lifted this boulder just enough so that Prahlad Maharaj is not crushed under the boulder. So all the demons thought that Prahlad has gone, is dead, and they go away. Meanwhile, Prahlad Maharaj is beautifully escorted from that place by Narayan and brought him back to the shore. and Prahlad Maharaj is so happy to see the beautiful form of Lord Narayan. But Lord Narayan then disappears because Lord has to come again in another form to appease Prahlad Maharaj. And later we know that how Prahlad Maharaj was finally being threatened by Hiranyakashipu himself to be killed, and then Lord Narasingdev came out of the pillar and killed Hiranyakashipu and saved Prahlad. So Prahlad became the king of the demons. He was ruling the whole kingdom which Hiranyakashipu ruled. So during one of his times when he was traveling, he came to this place again. And when he came to this place, he got reminded, this is a place where Lord appeared to protect me from that boulder being placed on my head while I was in a deep ocean. So he said that Prahlad Maharaj sat in deep meditation and he was worshipping the Lord. So in his mind, he began to worship the Lord, form of the Lord, Lord Narasingdev. And suddenly, he also remembered that Lord had come in another form yet as Lord Varahadev, and previously had killed Hiranyaksha, his uncle. So out came a very spiritual desire. Prahlad Maharaj prayed intensely to the Lord that he wanted to worship the Lord in a form which is both Narasingha and Varaha. So Lord appeared there and gave his own deity to Prahlad Maharaj and said, please worship this. This is Varaha Narasingha deity. So Varaha Narasingha deity is a very special deity. It has the face of Varahadev and the body and the tail of Narasingadev. So you have all the claws like a lion and tail like a lion, and the face is of Varaha. So Prahlad Maharaj was worshipping this deity. Because he got this deity on that hill, he named that hill called as Simha Hill or Simhachalam. So Prahlad Maharaj was worshipping the deity for many, many years, and finally ages passed by. Due to some reason or another, the whole temple was covered up, the temple was destroyed, only the deity remained. The deity was underground, buried inside. Lord was waiting for another devotee to appear and give him service. And way later, in the Lunar dynasty, it is mentioned that King Pururava appeared. And Pururava, he was actually a great devotee, but somehow that due to some improper association, he had fallen trap with a lot of attachment to Urvashi. So one particular time, it is mentioned that Pururava Maharaj and Urvashi were traveling on an airplane and going around having a good time with each other. So they saw this hill, and Urvashi and Pururava thought it's a very good place to come and to visit and have a good time with each other, enjoy with each other. So they came and they arrived at this hill. And Urvashi and Pururava were there. Now this hill is the same hill where Lord was there and buried inside underground. So Lord was thinking that such a nice devotee of mine, where has he fallen in trap with? I should rescue him. So it is mentioned that when Pururava and Urvashi were together, Lord came in the form of a boar, a wild boar. So when he came, Urvashi became frightened and Pururava became angry. So Pururava took a bow and arrow in the hand and ran after that boar to catch the boar and kill the boar. But the boar was not ordinary boar, it was Supreme Lord himself. So the boar went running and disappeared in one place. So Pururava was very surprised where the boar has gone. He came back. So because they liked this place, so they stayed in that place. So that particular night, Pururava Maharaj got a dream of Varaha Narasingadev. And he told him that kindly, don't forget me, I am your Lord and Master. You have been serving me for so long, now you have forgotten me. But kindly revive your relationship with me. Come and remove me from this underground, and you remove me and you worship me. So Pururava got a hint, and Pururava came to this very place. He removed the earth, and lo and behold, not very deep, just on the surface, Varaha Narasingadev Bhagavan appeared in front of him. So it got the deities out and started worshipping the deep. He made a small beautiful temple immediately for the protection of the Lord. As he was worshipping, Lord again appeared in his dream and said, well, the point is that I am feeling very hot because I have been underground for a long time, and plus I am the doubled incarnation of Varaha and Narasingha, whose only incarnation pastime was to kill Hiranyaksha and Hiranyakashipu. So I am very hot. So I need to be cooled down with Chandan. kindly arrange that you apply chandan all over my body. He gives specification also, and he said only on a particular day, Akshaya Tritiya, should my exact original form should be seen by all devotees. That means remove all the chandan Akshaya Tritiya, and the next day onwards start applying chandan again. So since that day, since the time of King Pururava, this tradition continues, where on the day of Akshaya Tritiya all the chandan is removed. The next day, that is today of ours, in the evening time, they will apply chandan. How much chandan they will apply? It is mentioned, Lord told Pururava Maharaj, that as much earth you removed while excavating my deity out, that much chandan you apply every time. So in this way, they apply four times that much chandan, and eventually Lord is fully covered over with chandan. So the first chandan is applied next day after Akshaya Tritiya. Then after that, the next chandan is applied on Vaishak Purnima, the same month Purnima they apply, and the next one Jeshta comes, Jeshta Purnima they apply another one, and finally Ashad Purnima. So finally by Ashad Purnima, then the whole deity of the Lord is nothing but like looks like a Shivalingam with full of chandan. So here again we see the Lord asks his devotee to apply chandan and cool him down. So this is the second instance we can see in the traditional narrations where Lord is coming in the dream of devotees and asking them to apply chandan to him. There are many more pastimes. One such pastime I remember is the pastime which comes in the 10th canto of Srimad Bhagavatam. This is Lord Krishna. He has come from Vrindavan to Mathura. Akrura has got Krishna from Vrindavan to Mathura. And now Krishna along with his coward boyfriends, they are so happy because they have come to Mathura city. It's a new place. They are always staying in village. Now this is an exciting thing. So as the coward friends of Krishna are walking by, they get a little annoyed. So Krishna asks, what happened? Why you are annoyed? Because such a nice place, we were visiting a new city here. I said, we have come to city, but we don't look like city dwellers. We have all clothes which are all from village. Why don't we also wear clothes which people in city wear here? So immediately Krishna saw this dhobi, this washerman, and then the whole pastime happens that how the washerman refuses to give Krishna clothes. Then Krishna kills the dhobi, takes the cloth and goes ahead to the next person, tailor, who stitches the clothes properly, right? And then those clothes are ordered, adorned by Krishna, Balaram and all the coward friends of Krishna. So now Shringar dressing is over. So Krishna immediately feels, we are coward boys. We can't be separated from garlands of flowers. So Krishna sees this florist Sudama, and Krishna enters into his house and asks, can you give us flowers, garlands for me and my friends? And immediately Sudama gets all the flower garlands and adorns Krishna and Balaram with all beautiful flower garlands. So now dress is done, garland is done, and Krishna remembers, now the time has come for chandan. As Krishna is walking past, it's a huge gate of Kamsa's palace he comes across, and just as he's walking past the main gate, right in front of Krishna, a young hunchback lady, she is carrying some paraphernalia in the hand and going towards the gate of Kamsa. Now this hunchback lady saw Krishna and she gets mesmerized by the beauty of Krishna. She had never seen someone so beautiful, and she falls in love with Krishna. It is mentioned Krishna saw the hunchback young lady, her name was Kubja, and immediately Krishna addressed her as, "Oh beautiful lady Kubja." So, and then Krishna asked, "You have such a beautiful chandan paste in your hand. Kindly give chandan paste to me and my friends. I will apply on the body." So Kubja immediately replies favorably. Kubja says that actually you are calling me Sundari, but I know you are joking with me. I am a hunchback lady. But nonetheless, because you are asking me for chandan, this chandan is actually for Kamsa. But I don't mind giving it to you. Somehow or other my heart feels I should serve all of you. So see, our acharyas mentioned the boldness of Kubja, the courage of Kubja's devotion. Kubja was standing just on the main gate of Kamsa. She was not having any fear. What if Kamsa watches from the palace and he comes to know that I am offering his chandan to his arch rival Krishna? then maybe he will kill me. Well, Kubja doesn't worry about all that. Kubja is only interested in serving Krishna. And therefore, when she served Krishna boldly, Krishna became very pleased. It mentioned Kubja personally offered with her hands chandan paste on the body of Krishna, on the body of Balaramji and all the coward friends of Krishna. And everyone is so pleased. So Krishna wanted to reciprocate. And Krishna then said, I have called you Sundar, I have called you very beautiful. Now I have to prove that. So that time Krishna, he held Kubja's feet with his feet and just took hold of the chin of Kubja and straightened her. And immediately Kubja, she became very straight. From hunchback lady, she became a straight lady with beautiful bodily features. In fact, her beauty increased a lot because she beautified the body of Krishna. So this is another pastime of Krishna wanted sandalwood paste. And Kubja, by offering little sandalwood paste, she became a great devotee of Krishna. There are many such stories in Shastra. Let us see one more story. This is in Banaras, Varanasi. This comes in the famous book of Ramacharitamanas. It is mentioned that a very great Vaishnava saint, Tulsidas, he is a great devotee of Lord Ramachandra, and he was very well known for his Ramayana narrations. Now we know that famous incident of how Lord Ram went with all of his associates back home, back to Godhead, but he kept Hanumanji behind. And he told Hanumanji that wherever my Ramayana has been recited, you should go there and you should purify that place and in this way enthuse devotees to chant Ramayana. So Tulsidas Goswami, he was very well known for his recitation of Ramayana. However, he was not there to recite Ramayana for anyone else. He was doing it for his own self as a devotion to Lord Ramachandra. So in one ghat of Banaras, Banaras is known for many ghats, one particular ghat of Banaras, Tulsidas Goswami would sit every day and would recite Ramayana with his closed eyes. When he would open his eyes after the narration was over, he would see a huge crowd of people just sitting down there, completely enraptured in the Katha of Ram sung by Saint Tulsidas. So he would become very, he would also become very shy, and then he would go away from that place. But this would happen every day, because who would stop a pure devotee from not reciting Lord Ram's glories? He would do it every day. Then one day he felt, my devotion I want to offer as a personal thing, but I see that a lot of people are coming and I'm getting a lot of recognition, appreciation. So one day he decided that let me go to one place where there is no one who would see me and would come next to me and hear my Ramayana, so that I will myself get absorbed. So Tulsidas Goswami chose the forest very close to his Banaras, and he went to the forest. He found a nice tree and sat under a tree, and he used to recite Ramayana, and he would open his eyes and he would find no one is there. So he was very happy, contented that this Ramayana is for the pleasure of the Lord, not for any audience. He sat there for 7 days and recited Ramayana every single day. And suddenly then he felt that now time has come, let me go back to Banaras, and there I will do some other service of doing some other seva or puja as Lord Ram wants. As he was about to leave, the tree under which he was sitting every day and reciting, the branch of the tree broke. And suddenly the Tulsidas Goswami was thinking, from where the sound is coming? And right in front of him, a personality came who had a ghost body. A ghost appeared in front of him. Tulsidas Goswami said, who are you? And the ghost started laughing, said, oh Tulsidas ji, thank you very much. I was suffering in this ghost body, and because of this torture, I was torturing so many people coming here. I was suffering for so many years. But just because you came here and you recited Ramayana for so many days, by hearing that Ramayana from your lotus lips, I have got purified from this ghostly body, and now I am getting delivered from the ghostly body, and I am going to go ahead in my destination. So the ghost, he relinquished his ghostly body, got a divine body and went to the higher planets. Some say he also went to Vaikuntha. However, before he left, he wanted to do some service to Tulsidas Maharaj. So Tulsidas Goswami said, you want to do some service, Guru Dakshina? Well, I am waiting for an audience of Lord Ram. Can you let me know when will a time come when I'll be able to see Lord Ram in my life? And the ghost said, well, it's a very difficult question to answer for me, because I am a ghostly person. I got benefited by you. How I can tell you that what benefits you? But I can give a clue. Well, you go back to the same place where you recite Ramayana every day on Banaras Ghat. And there a personality comes every day to hear your Ramayana. That's Hanumanji. You ask this question to Hanumanji, he will tell you where you will find your Ram. So Tulsidas said, I never saw Ram Hanumanji in my katha. So he comes incognito. Go there and keep your eyes closed. Pretend that your eyes are closed, but keep watching. When you begin your katha, the first person who comes in the katha sits very far behind with a blanket on his head, on his body. That's Hanumanji. He will go through the whole katha and he will be the last person to leave also. So immediately Tulsidas Goswami got a wonderful, this idea was wonderful. So he went immediately to Banaras Ghat and then he started reciting Ramayana, and lo and behold, people started gathering, and with his closed eyes, with little open, he also saw the first person to enter was a person with a blanket on. That was Hanumanji. No one could see him. And the katha was going on. When the katha got over, as everyone left, and Hanumanji with his blanket was leaving, that was the time Tulsidas Goswami went and jumped and caught the feet of Hanumanji. Hanumanji, today I have caught you, you cannot leave me. So Hanumanji was very pleased. Hanumanji said, you speak so nice Ramayana. Just to hear your Ramayana, I come every day. So then Tulsidas Goswami said, I am just asking for one blessing from you. What is the blessing? You are always close to Lord Ram. Can I ever get an opportunity to see Lord Ram? So Hanumanji said, yes, but that requires a lot of patience. Are you ready for that patience? And Tulsidas Goswami said, why not? Utsaha Nishya Dhairyat. Right? The six limbs of bhakti, which is favorable for execution of bhakti. Enthusiasm, confidence, and patience. So it was Hanumanji who sent Tulsidas Goswami Maharaj to Chitrakoot and told, you go to Chitrakoot on the banks of Mandakini Ganga, you do only one seva. Every day you grind chandan. You grind chandan every day and apply to the deities of Lord Ram is there. But lo and behold, remember, you keep grinding every day. One day Lord will personally come and ask for your chandan. So it happened so. It is mentioned that for many days, we don't know how many days, but it was every day grinding chandan on the banks of Mandakini Ganga. And one particular day, Lord Ram stood in front of him. This devotee was completely immersed singing of Lord Ram and grinding chandan. And Lord Ram, can I get some chandan? And opened his eyes, saw his beautiful Lord Ramchandra there. So there's a beautiful kavya, small poetry which comes in the famous Hindi tradition of Ramayana. They say this, Chitrakoot ke ghat pe bhai santan ki bheed, Tulsidas chandan ghise tilak det raghuveer. So he was applying, he was grinding chandan, and finally with his hand he applied chandan on the body of Lord Ramchandra. And then Lord Ramchandra told him to go back to Banaras and told him that a very place you are speaking Ramayana, there if you dig, you will find a beautiful deity of Hanumanji who is a guru, who sent you to me. Establish a beautiful temple of Hanumanji there and stay there and write down all your literatures which compose of Lord Ramchandra's pastimes. So it is mentioned that at this place, he got a deity of Hanumanji called as Sankat Mochan and established a beautiful temple there. And on the banks, on the temple there, while sitting there, it is mentioned that Tulsidas Goswami wrote down this Ramayana. It became famous as Ramacharitamanas. So this is another pastime of Lord asking, or the devotee getting glorified because of applying chandan on the body of the Lord. So there are many pastimes like this about chandan. Now we will also see about various scriptures mentioning the importance of chandan and application of chandan and the importance and the collection on analogy of chandan with our spiritual life. Now there is a nice shloka which comes in Shubhashit. Shubhashit is actually Alankar scripture which gives beautiful analogies to teach life's very succinct lessons. So this is a very beautiful verse which comes in the one Shubhashit. चंदनम शीतलम लोके, चंदनम शीतलम लोके, चंदनात अपि चंद्रमा, चंदना चंदनम शीतलम लोके, चंदनात अपि चंद्रमा, चंद्र चंदनयोर, चंद्र चंदनयोर मध्ये शीतल साधु संगह, शीतल साधु संगति. सो द सुभाषित मेंशंस दैट what is coolest thing in this earth planet? The coolest thing on this earth planet is chandan, sandalwood. Chandanam sheetalam loke. But cooler than chandan is a heavenly planet called as moon planet. Chandanat api chandrama. So now two sheetal things are mentioned, cool things. Chandan and moon, both are cool. However, it is mentioned here, चंद्र चंदनयोर मध्ये, बट बियॉन्ड चंद्र एंड चंदनयोर, इन बोथ ऑफ देम चंद्र एंड चंदनयोर मध्ये शीतल साधु संगति. यस, द कूलेस्ट थिंग इज द एसोसिएशन ऑफ डिवोटी, साधु संगति, बिकॉज इन दैट एसोसिएशन वी कैन ओवरकम द स्कॉर्चिंग हीट ऑफ संसार. संसार दावा नललीढ लोका, त्राणाय कारुण्य घना घनत्वं, प्राप्तस्य कल्याण गुणानुवर्षे, वंदे गुरुः श्री चरणारविंदम. सो दिस मटेरियल वर्ल्ड इज कंपेयर टू अ फॉरेस्ट फायर, वेरी हॉट. इन द एसोसिएशन ऑफ डिवोटीज वी गेट दैट कूलिंग शेड, कूलिंग शेड. देयर इज वन मोर सुभाषित विच मेंशन सिमिलरली वन मोर अफेक्ट ऑफ चंदन, क्वालिटीज ऑफ चंदन. इट इज शैले शैले न माणिक्यम मौतिकम न गजे गजे, साधु नाही सर्वत्र चंदनम न वने वने. शैले शैले न माणिक्यम, इन एवरी शैल यू ओपन इट यू विल नॉट फाइंड अ मणी और अ पर्ल. माणिक्यम, शैले शैले न माणिक्यम, मौतिकम न गजे गजे, इन एवरी एलिफेंट्स हेड यू वोंट फाइंड अ मोती, अ पर्ल. It's only in rarest of rare elephants you will find a pearl in the head of the elephant. Motikam na gaje gaje, sadhu nahi sarvatra chandanam na vane vane. The shloka ends with chandanam na vane vane. You can go to any forest, but in all forest you will not find chandan trees. Only few forest chandanam na vane vane. Just like you can't find chandan tree in all forest, only few. Just like you can't find pearl in every shell, you can't find pearl in every elephant. Similarly, sadhu nahi sarvatra, to get association of devotees is very rare. You will find only rarely, and when you have it, take full advantage of it. So there are many more shlokas like this. We have in wonderful shloka in Srimad Bhagavatam of Kunti Maharani. Kunti Maharani is praying to Lord Krishna when Lord Krishna wants to depart in Dwapar Yuga. So it is mentioned that Kunti Maharani offers his beautiful prayers. Kechid ahur ajam jata punya shlokasya kirtaye yado yado priyasyan vaya yado priyasyan vavaya malas malayasyeva chandanam. So again, malayasyeva chandanam. Here the Malaya Chandan is described. Why the example is given? Kunti Maharani says, Kechid Ahur Ajam Jata. It is said, some say, Kunti Maharani says that some people say that the unborn is born for glorification of pious kings. And Kunti says, but others, they have a different opinion. They say that Lord Krishna was born to please his great devotee Yadu Maharaj, and therefore he was born in Yadukul. So Kunti Devi is saying that some say that this, some say that, but whatever everyone says, ultimately it is not that Lord Krishna became famous in Yadu dynasty. It is opposite. Wherever Lord Krishna is there, that dynasty becomes famous. Nothing can bind Krishna. Krishna is Swarat, but wherever he goes, then he makes that place, that person famous. And the example is Malayasya Chandanam. Sandalwood is famous, But when sandalwood is grown in Malaya forest, then that sandalwood gets name Malaya Chandanam. Malaya becomes famous because of Chandan. Doesn't mean that Chandan is famous because of Malaya hills. No. So these are the different scriptural references of Chandan. I'll complete my class with two more anecdotes. One is another story of a great pujari who gives an analogy of serving the Lord, compares his own life as Chandan, and then finally we'll wrap up with Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's pastimes with Chandan. So I heard this story many years back. This was during one of the yatras we went. So we were hearing the kathas in different places when we went for yatra, and one particular place, a very lonely temple was there, and there was a pujari who was 90 years old serving that temple. He was there alone, no one else, and there are beautiful deities there. So during the lecture, after the lecture was over, then the devotees interacted with him and they asked him, how long you are serving here? He said he came to this temple when he was a very small kid, 9-year-old boy, and since then he's staying here. Eventually the pujari was there who gave him the worship, and he's worshiping the deity since age of 9 to 90. Such a long life just in a small remote temple. So gradually, very kind of, you know, devotees in city, they always are very intrigued. Someone can stay for 81 years in one place. So they ask, "Aye, tumko bore laga nahi kya? You didn't feel any bore in doing it?" Of course, this question, only questions can be asked to a city dweller. That person, pujari, said, "What bore was there? Nothing bore, you know, such a nice thing." So another devotee asked that, "You are serving this temple for so many years. You have served the Lord almost your whole life. Don't you feel in your life, in your heart, that Lord never gave you facilities? You are still living in a very poor condition. Temple is just somehow maintained." So the pujari just smiled. The 19-year-old pujari said, he quoted the story, an analogy of a chandan. He said that the sandalwood tree, if it has to be applied on the body of the Lord, has to undergo a lot of tribulation, right? The sandalwood tree is standing, for it has to, first it has to be cut, and the bark which is there has to be removed, right? And finally each branches has to be chopped down into further small logs or small pieces, and finally then it comes in the hands of a devotee or a pujari, and then rubs the chandan, grinds the chandan on a granite surface. So there is so much of torture, so much of anxiety, so much of anguish the chandan has to undergo. First as a beautiful tree, then cut down, then logs, then scraped open, the bark has gone, and finally the grinding takes place, and finally chandan comes out, and then the chandan is applied on the body of the Lord. So this pujari said, well, the chandan has to undergo all that process so that it can reach the Lord. If the chandan decides, well, I don't want this anguish, let me remain how I am, why I have to be grinded and the whole bark has to be removed and cut like that. So pujari said, if you don't do that, if chandan does not do that, then what will chandan be used as? Finally, someone will come and cut the branches of chandan and use it for the funeral cremation of some person. So this pujari said, the body has to be used in Krishna's service. The body will undergo a lot of tribulation, but finally the end result will be the body is used in Lord's Seva. Such a nice example of chandan being used for one's own existence, of how the body, the mind, everything will go through distortions, so many upheavals, but if a devotee persists, the devotee can finally find place at the lotus feet of Krishna. So we are coming back to the last pastime of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So there is a beautiful verse which comes in the Chaitanya Bhagavat. It is also quoted in Chaitanya Charitamrita. It is from actually Mahabharata. The verse is, Suvarna Varna Himango Varangas Chandanangadi. Suvarna Varna Himango. The Lord Gauranga, he has come in the form which is golden in color. Suvarna Varna Himango. Himango, every whole body is golden. And then Varangas Chandanangadi, So description of Lord Gauranga is given that Lord will appear in this age of Kali Yuga and he will inaugurate a Sankirtan Andolan, Sankirtan movement. And what will happen is the body of the color of the body of Lord is molten, the gold color, and on that gold color there is beautiful Varangas Chandanangari. Lord has appeared beautiful Chandan on his body. So now the gold has become molten gold. So Srila Prabhupada gives purport to one of these shlokas in Chaitanya Charitamrita. And Srila Prabhupada mentions in that beautiful translation and purport that here there is a description of initially Lord Gauranga having sandalwood pulp, and the next few lines is about Lord doing Sankirtan, inaugurating Sankirtan Yajna in this age of Kali Yuga, and delivering all fallen souls. Srila Prabhupada says the first two lines, it depicts the Lord Gauranga Mahaprabhu's former life in Navadvip as a householder. And the last two lines depict Lord Gauranga as a sannyasi when he is going and preaching and delivering fallen souls. So amazing, Srila Prabhupada points out that when Lord Gauranga was in his household pastimes, he was known as Nimaya Pandit. So every day without fail, when Nimaya would walk out of the house after taking bath in Ganga, he would decorate his body. And part of his decoration every single day was chandan leaf on his forehead. And then he would walk, and everyone would be attracted to the beauty of Lord Gauranga as a beautiful Pandit, Sanskrit scholar, establishing himself as the most authentic and undefeatable scholar in Navadvip Dham, which was a seat of learning, like Oxford University or Cambridge University or Harvard of that time. Navadvip was famous, and that time, in those era of learned scholars, Lord Gauranga stood front. He could teach everyone something which others would take years, he would teach them in months or weeks. So Lord Gauranga performed this pastime 24 years, mirrored with Chandan, he would go out and perform these scholastic pastimes. And then he began Sankirtan Yajna, then Lord Gauranga decided to take sannyas. Now as sannyasi, Lord Gauranga was very austere. He did not want any alankar, anything. And what to speak of Chandan? But Lord Gauranga kept that association of Chandan even after he took sannyas. What was the thing? Lord Gauranga made sure that the Chandan is applied on the body of the Lord as well as on the body of the devotees. So there are many occasions where Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu would be very happy when he would greet his devotees with mala and Chandan. There are so many pastimes like this. One pastime I remember is Lord Gauranga was in Jagannath Puri. And in Jagannath Puri, it is mentioned that every year for Rath Yatra, before Rath Yatra, devotees from Bengal and Orissa would all come to stay for 3-4 months, and they would take part in Rath Yatra and also take association of Lord Gauranga Mahaprabhu. And every single year, Lord Gauranga Mahaprabhu would welcome all these devotees on the outskirts of Puri. There is a beautiful place even today called as Athar Nala. Lord Gauranga would stand there, and as soon as devotees would come in, it is mentioned Chaitanya Mahaprabhu would garland them and offer them Chandan paste on their foreheads, each and every devotee. So this is how we can see that Lord Gauranga Mahaprabhu also had a very powerful connection with this Chandan festival, Chandan Yatra thing. Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also took part in Chandan Yatra festival in Lord Jagannath's temple in Jagannath Puri. So in this way there are innumerable pastimes of Lord with Chandan, and therefore the Chandan Yatra is not just an ordinary festival, it's a mega festival, it's a well-known festival, and devotees look for this festival so they get chance to grind Chandan for the Lord and smear the Chandan on the face of the Lord, on the body of the Lord, to apparently make him cool. And when the Mahachandan comes, they honor Chandan by eating, or they offer Chandan on their body, and this way they make themselves cool down by the cooling effect of Chandan, and the mind becomes soothed. Mind is very the mind gets soothed by the beautiful fragrance of Chandan, and in this way Krishna consciousness prospers. Thank you so much. Hare Krishna. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Chandan Yatra Maha Mahotsav ki jai.
RG Media YouTube channel. Like, share, subscribe.